We get too religious. And religion is killing the body of Christ. We get too formal. And formalism is killing the body of Christ. And as we begin to get formal and religion, the enemy creep right in and have a seat comfortably.
Amen. That's true.
There is no fear of God. No. There is no fear that when I get in this place, I'm going to be trouble.
Come on now.
Yeah. It's time for us to trouble the devil.
Yeah.
Too long the devil was troubling the people of God. And they said, these things shall come. No, no, giant. You shall die just by you making noise like that. Let me tell you that part. But you have to gear up in the spirit of God. You got to get in the secret place of the Most High and abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And so when you gear up at that devil, because so much time the devil look at the statue. In other words, they look at your outer appearance. And so you look like you are mute and you can't kill a fly. And so they kick up a lot of fire. We got this one. Oh, it's not gonna happen. We gonna lock this one. But it's time for those Davids to stand up in the armor of prayer and the armor of supplication, in the armor of consecration, in the armor of my God, of great deliverance, in the armor of victory, in the armor of an overcomer, in the armor of giant, in the armor of the anointed. I say I've been rejected, I've been cast aside, but my God, God will lead me in the paths of righteousness, and I got to speak to my giant, you shall die.
Yes!
It looked like it's the truth.
Mm.
They got you this time. So what? That's the time you get stupid. That's the time you move from the norm. That's the time you take off your high heel. That's the time you wear your hair natural because you're going crazy now. That's the time you find a long dress for some stupid things is going to happen. So what, devil? I'm a warrior. Warriors don't quit. Warriors don't die. You will put me in the pit. You will put me in the field. But I shall rise. I shall rise. It looked bad. It looked bad in the eyes of religion people. Religious people. The scribe and the Pharisees, it looked hot. You want the hottest news.
That's right.
So whatever. Because God is getting ready to assault me. And so while I got on the hot news, I put on my warfare clothes and I began to war in the spirit. I say, devil, show your best show. But I ain't given the opportunity to show. Throw that dagger.
Jesus.
So whatever.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
When they thought they had conquered our Savior, they didn't find any fault in him. But the people said, crucify him. There was no evidence. The people say, the people.
Yeah. People.
The people say,
yes, yes, yes.
Crucify him.
My God. No evidence.
No evidence.
And they took him. The enemy didn't even want to crucify him because he knew there was no evidence.
That's right.
But it was his own.
Yes.
It gets sometimes like that. It's your own.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Mm. And sometimes when we're here, my God, Jesus, weapon the scriptures. Yeah. Sometimes you say, oh, that's the condition. But when your own injury, you disappear.
Yeah.
Because when you go to the place of refuge, there's no refuge. Yeah. There is toys. The enemy been bothering you. And you go for refuge. And the people of God just strike the tiger in you. So what? Stop being a baby. Get yourself together. So they took him.
Jesus, my God.
Thank you, Jesus.
They took him to that cross. And they just didn't took him there. They whipped him. They put taunts on him. They spat on him. Oh, my God. Whatever name they could have called him, they called Jesus. So who is you and me? You better gear up yourself in this place. Who is you and me? Now we gonna play the fool, oh God, and say, God, day, I don't care what they say, what God has to say, because he has the final say. And so, they took him to that cross. They didn't whisper in the teeth of the robbers. They pierced his hand. They pierced him. That blood drained from him. Oh my God. There was rejoicing and victory. Oh boy, they pitch a party that night. Oh God, you know what it is, the sins of God to pitch a party on you. Oh God, that's the most hurtfulest thing in the world. They pitch a party on you. Oh God, God, God. You get wounded and beaten and you just need someone to say, I'm praying with you, but they pitching a party on you.
Hallelujah.
And so glory to God, while they were pitching that pipe, my Savior died.
Glory.
When he went to that grave.
Glory. Glory.
On the third day, he arise. And he took back the key of death. And so with the devil, whoever the devil had in bondage with death, they had no more victory. God had positioned you for this sin time. You may be in your pit now. You may be in your fiery furnace now. But God is going to come true for you. And he's going to put you on the mountain. Gentiles. We was not called it, you know. We was not a part of this, you know. Now, we are a part of the kingdom of God. God, for we are saved through grace. My God, because the Bible said he came to his own and his own received him. He went through that. And the thing about it is, he didn't have to take one day of that pain.
That's right.
He could have killed every one of his enemies immediately.
That's right.
You know how some of us is, we had him. You mess with me, I take out my gun fast and knock you out. But he didn't do it, but he could have done it. But he endured. He took it in because he knew greater and greatness was about to come through it.
Amen.
Sometimes as saints, we want a flowery bed. We want an easy bed. I want to sleep big and hard, big and tall, big and walk big. But you need to gear up in the anointing big. You need to gear up in your prayer big. You need to be in that word and be a giant in that word. You need to weep before the porch and the altar and non-stop cry. You know when them groanings get within, you cannot utter a word. All you can say, Jesus. That's where he wants us to be big. Sometimes it passing you and Jesus. There was not even a word to speak. And all you could say, oh, Jesus. But behind that, oh, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And sometimes you lay in your bed at night and sleep cannot even hit your body.
Yes, Lord.
And you all you can do is groan and say, oh, Jesus.
That's it. Yes, yes, yes.
It's time to gear up. It's time to gear up, David. I'm speaking to the young and the old. It's time to gear up. It's time to put on the armor you have proven. You know why we lose in the battle? Because we have on the wrong armor.
That's right. That's it.
God never called you to sing like the full Baptist ministry.
Amen.
We are Holy Ghost rollers, tongue talkers, believing in the baptism of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
He ain't called you to turn up all the lights. You haven't proven that armor, man. Take off that armor, man, and get in the anointing and the armor you have proven and begin to worship your God. Too much time we put up things that is not of us. God didn't call you in that way. Don't tell me what the other church was doing.